To Tangata Pasifika. This week we have a special half-hour show for you looking at the history of Pacific people on telly.
That's right. As part of TVNZ's celebration of 50 years of TV, we take a look back to when Islanders first started colouring up New Zealand TV screens, right through to what's happening on air today.
Here's Lisa Taoma with this special report.
TVNZ is celebrating 50 years of bringing TV to the nation. But finding a brownie on screen in the 70s and 80s in New Zealand was slim pickings. New Zealanders first became familiar with Pacific people on the telly through images like these.
Two cops that come in, the next minute there was another two that come in.
Then one day, there weren't enough jobs either. The people became angry, and violence broke out. Especially among those who had come from other places expecting great things.
The first Pacific person to warm the hearts of the nation and be claimed as a national icon on the telly was rugby legend Brian Williams.
Williams! That is a great try in anyone's language.
We're often glimpsed as backup singers and dancers on shows like Radio Times with Billy T. James. And then in the mid-80s, Ole Maiapa became one of the first Pacific TV presenters on iconic Kiwi kids shows, Spot On.
Kia ora. Welcome to a new series of Spot On.
There's a lot more exciting things happening in children's television at that point in time.
Now this one here has to be dragged 7 metres.
I knew I was slightly different because my approach was different, and of course I sort of grew up in Porirua, so it was a different, I came with a different sort of swagger, I suppose, and I was a little bit more real in my approach and closer to that audience, I suppose, in that sense.
Hi guys.
They never trained us in those days, and you're in the studio. Arrived on a Monday, was in the studio on a Thursday, was on air on Sunday. I was the only brown person in this whole building full of white people, and that was weird.
Ollie was also cast in the drama series Roach, which went to air at the same time as he appeared for the first time on Spot On.
I was playing this overstaying boxer that couldn't speak English.
I won't go to bed.
I would like a licking, not want.
So I had this really fob accent in it. And I happened, in it was a dawn raid.
We're government official.
Fire.
We're from the Department of Immigration.
Liaia Leakey, you're immigration.
And of course, that weekend in the paper, after it went to air, there was this thing from the immigration, and they had my photo on the front page of the Dominion, and they were saying to me, you know, this is the dawn raid were portrayed badly. So there I was, thrown up onto this page, not only as a through Spot On, but also with this other episode, which is weird.
Country GP was one of New Zealand's earliest local dramas and saw the first Samoan actor ever cast in a lead role on New Zealand TV, Lani Tupu.
Date of birth, March the 12th, 1871.
As an actor, starting off in a young actor and a Samoan actor and Polynesian actor, it was a big, big ride for me, and that ride hasn't really stopped.
Lani was then cast in the drama series Marlin Bay as the owner of a big flash country casino.
All I knew was that I had to be really good at what I was doing as an actor. I knew that there weren't too many brown faces out there, and really it came down to me being, you know, really damn good at what I was doing and loving what I was doing. And maybe because of that, people didn't really see any kind of colour. I remember someone ringing up when the show went to air and swore at me. I had no idea who it was to this day. And so that was my first initiation into, you know, the flip side of being in the public eye.
Also in the public eye at the time was Samoan Natalie Brunt, who was a hit as the face of Crime Watch.
Crime Watch is your chance to help them with information.
Please call.
See Here started in 1981 as a 5-minute slot during the day aimed at Māori and Pacific Island people.
diabetes is a common illness amongst Maori and Pacific Island people.
And in 1987, Tangata Pasifika aired for the first time. On TV2 at 11 a.m. on Saturdays, the show gave Pacific people their own regular voice on air.
Kia ora koutou katoa toa and welcome.
The political turmoil in Vanuatu was aggravated this week when 18 parliamentary opposition members were all sacked.
There was a meeting called at TVNZ and the community came and we all put in our thoughts about how we need to have a half-hour program, a real, like a magazine program, promoting our artists, our singers, our cultures, our languages. We are going to tell New Zealand we are here to stay and we make up the tapestry of this country. It was a wonderful time of changing the look of television on air. Here you are, Polynesian people with flowers in their ear, the headgear, and colourful people, big people, small people, old people. We're not gonna, you know, this is who we are, so what have we got to be ashamed of?